first text is kind of odd to end on, and you'll hear why in a minute.
Ooh! Oh.
Must
So, if you saw something different in your text, that's what would happen.
Thank you. second and third song. So we'll be singing Now, Oh Now, followed by my Flow My Tears, and then Lend Your Ears. I'd also love to talk a little bit about the songs. I tend to talk too much, so I'm going to limit myself. but what I find so interesting about Dowland's songs is that they're, of course, they're beautiful and we're used to the tunes, but what most of us are unaware of is what the text meant to the people of the time that listened to them. And most of them understood that, that a lot of these were kind of subversive messages to Queen Elizabeth I. The first song, Now, Oh Now, is known as the Frog Galliard. And actually, the last man that she considered marrying, the Duc d'Anjou, she called her frog. And so this song of farewell was really her saying goodbye to her chance at happiness with a man. He was a French Catholic, and of course, she was ruling Protestant England, and her Privy Council talked her out of the marriage. The second two songs I find particularly interesting because she did have one other love interest toward the end of her life, the much younger Robert Devereux, the Earl of Essex. And they had a very contentious relationship, mostly because he was ambitious and wanted to be king. And she was not very interested in being subservient to anyone. So when he got a little bit too ambitious, she would send him away. And many of his letters in entreating her to let him come back to court had a lot of the same imagery as Flow My Tears. And eventually, he gathered together a few people and marched on the castle and tried to take over in a coup d'etat, and that's treason. So he was executed in 1601. And by all accounts, in the 2 years between his execution and her death, she was extremely regretful that she had to sentence him to execution. And Lend Your Ears to My Sorrow really talks about her grief over having to do that. The last piece, what is the last piece? Yes, His Golden Locks, was actually first performed at the tilts, or the jousting ceremonies that were held in her honor. And this was, by all accounts, the first Dowland song performed for Queen Elizabeth. So I hope that gives you a little bit of context. I find it fascinating, and I hope you enjoy knowing a little bit more about it. Joy once fled cannot return. choo-choo.